All great stadiums are different, but they do share a common bond. They become electric when athletes perform. Arizona boasts a grand venue, the 16th at the TPC of Scottsdale, where the best in the game have delivered some thrilling moments. This week, the top players in the world are back once again to duel in the desert with the stadium course. Hundreds of thousands are on hand to witness the drama surrounding one of golf's greatest stages, the true definition of the word.
CBS Sports proudly presents the PGA Tour from the Tournament Players Club of Scottsdale in Scottsdale, Arizona. CBS Sports presents the FBR Open Late Night Show.
Day two, FBR Open, Scottsdale, Arizona. Welcome, everybody, to the Late Night Show. I'm your host, Gary McCord. This is my partner, David Feherty. And David, another perfect day. We haven't had rain here in a long time, but there's a lot of people who showed up today.
114 days without rain, but they're finding it somewhere. This golf course is perfect, and 117,000 people turned up to watch the golf today. Let's see how the guys did.
Well, a lot of them are following this group right here. Phil Mickelson and Vijay Singh right there, a two-time Phoenix Open champion. Bombs it off the 18th hole. Just a little sand wedge. Leaves him about 8 feet away for his birdie. And Vijay with thousands watching. Yeah, makes him a little applause right there. Three under par, he made the cut.
Overnight leader Steve Lowry now. That for birdie on the 9th. And again on the 13th. Rolling the ball beautifully. The putting surfaces are just perfect here. 65, 68 for Steve Lowry, 9 under par. Now Mickelson.
ASU grad right down the street, Phil Mickelson, really had it going today, just laser-like irons. This is second shot on the 14th hole, very difficult par four, and Phil went on to make that. Now on the 17th hole, this drivable par four.
From a horrible lie just short of the green, what a piece of judgment this was.
Got the weight absolutely perfect on this, and he goes on to make that putt for his birdie. And now makes the turn. Second shot on the first hole. Over the blimp. And into the hole. Nothing but net. Oh, no. Just missed it. But goes on to make that birdie, a 66, with a double bogey on the last hole.
But the story of the day, J.J. Henry on the 14th hole. That was for birdie.
Now, on the 15th hole, that's a seventh in a row.
Which would make this a record on the next hole, should he make it. That close. That close.
But undisturbed, he goes to the next hole and says, "That's this one." Jesper Parnovic's going to walk it right in. Yes, he did. Okay, not bad going out, 32, but watch all the circles on this 9.
That will be 61. That's low.
J.B. Holmes, the rookie, the 23-year-old, 64 of his own. Phil Mickelson, you see right there, 66 at 7 under, but 7 shots back. Sergio Garcia missed the cut. Also, Tom Lehman.
Well, coming up, McCord makes the ultimate sacrifice. He caddies for the missus. But that's not the only sacrifice we've made here over the years in Phoenix. Some of the stuff we did just is plain wrong.
The FBR Open Late Night Show is sponsored by the Friedman Billings Ramsey, capital for your conquest.
One of the great traditions here at the FBR Open is Spousal Tuesday. It's the Tour Wives Classic, and the guys have to pack the sack.
I've always wondered who wore the pants in this relationship. It seems fairly obvious now. Who's in charge? Oh, it's in the water. Downhill from here.
Oh. One, two, four.
Oh, yeah. Right over here.
Wow. Three, four, five, six.
I would love to stand and watch. I would, but I've got to go and see a man about a horse.
Excellent.
Look at this. Look at this. It's see through with the ring in the
and
inside
the
and the bling over here. Is it any good? Wow.
This is a fun group, isn't it?
Work. I gotta get back to the late night show. That's a lot easier. Albeit I am with Feherty, and that might offset this whole thing.
You know, that was a pretty fair fashion show, apart from anything else, and some pretty good golf from the ladies, but I was very disappointed, I have to tell you, in the behavior of the caddies. It was absolutely typical. There was smoking, there was drinking, you turned up late, you didn't take orders well. It was absolutely typical.
Yeah, but the girls raised a lot of money for charity, so good for you guys. Fantastic job. And by the way, speaking of fantastic jobs, this is our last late night show in Phoenix, Arizona. 8 years of doing this.
Yes, it is. And I remember some lowlights. Let's take a look at them.
I swear we've been through everything there is. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine anything the two of us can't do.
I'm all in.
He hasn't dealt a card yet?
Islands in the stream, that is what we are.
I was born in a field in Ireland, raised by sheep. I got this poker face from an old ram called Lenny.
No! Feherty, go deep!
The game is golf. The men who play it best become heroes.
Yes!
The men who play it our way, well, they end up on the late night show.
David, that brings back some old memories. Remember the time we had to get from here to the other desert, Palm Springs, about 3 hours away, and CBS wouldn't pay for airfare?
We didn't always fly first class. This was one road trip I'll never forget.
Well, David, I guess that show last week really impressed them at CBS.
Oh, yeah, first class travel all the way from Phoenix.
McCord, I've lost control of my ass! Go, go!
Come on.
Until we meet again.
Water. Water. I lost my ass.
What have I done? I've killed him! Look at the size of that nose. Am I gonna get to be the co-host?
Who wouldn't want this job? We'll be right back.
Six years on the tour, J.J. Henry, no wins, but he has got a four-shot lead over J.B. Holmes, the 23-year-old from Campbellville, Kentucky. Phil Mickelson, seven shots back, and we got a bunch of good players missing this cut. Come and join us tomorrow, 3 o'clock, CBS. Well, David, it's supposed to be another perfect day tomorrow. We could have upwards of 160,000 to 170,000 people here. And for two kids on the leaderboard that haven't played in front of all these people, J.J. Henry and J.B. Holmes, this could be interesting.
Not really.